the sound, vocabulary that sounds from the planet lexicon. Watch out, villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check. Oh, girl! Huggy faces by her side, vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that crime will pay, then throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl.
Listen for the words extravaganza and antonym.
Ah, Saturday morning at the Botsfords. So quiet, so peaceful, so...
Okay, everybody, let's get it together! Food goes on the picnic table, Dad. Not much time before the guests arrive.
I'm cooking as fast as I can!
Gotta get that teeter-totter set up, Mom. Chop-chop!
Yes, teeter-totter!
Right back at you, Bob. Good work!
Becky, what's going on?
I'm throwing a party, TJ. And not just any party. I'm throwing an opposite day party. It's going to be huge. It's going to be spectacular. It's going to be an extravaganza.
Opposite day?
You sound confused, so I will gladly explain. Opposite day is a special day where we do and say the opposite of what we normally do and say. Once the party begins, everything will be the opposite of what it normally is. See, on opposite day, that isn't a teeter-totter. It's... Mom?
Oh, it's a totter teeter!
And on opposite day, we eat in reverse order. Ice cream for dinner, meatloaf for dessert.
Cool.
But the best part of opposite day is how we all talk. Instead of asking for what you want and saying how you feel, on opposite day, you ask for what you don't want and say the opposite of how you feel. Here, read this.
You are not invited to the worst party ever, Becky Botsford's Opposite Day Extravaganza. This sounds like the kind of party Word Girl might like. Could you imagine if she showed up? It won't happen. I can't even think about it.
Well, I, for one, hope there's no crime today in the entire city so Word Girl doesn't have to show up anywhere. Opposite Day. There's nothing better than an entire afternoon filled with antonyms.
Meanwhile, out at sea...
My sail! It is fixable. It can be repaired. It is fine! Fine? No! Destroyed! I must find a new sail for my boat! Soon! Soon! No! No! No care!
Before we begin, allow me to explain the number one rule of this party. You must say the opposite of what you actually mean. And if you make a mistake, there are no do-overs. So say the opposite. Use lots of antonyms. To help me demonstrate how it works, here is Bob the Monkey. Now, if I want cotton candy, I need to say, I don't want cotton candy. See? I asked for the opposite and got what I wanted. You make a mistake and say it with me, there are
no do-overs!
Yes, and that's how things work on opposite day. Now I'd like to officially kick off the festivities by wishing all of you a truly terrible afternoon! Opposite day!
Boo!
That's a spirit, everyone!
Remember to save room for dessert. Meatloaf for dessert. What's going on?
Trampoline made for bouncing. Not bouncing. Very difficult.
Oh! I'm having a terrible time on opposite day. How about you, Scoops?
I'm having fun at this party.
So, you mean you're actually having a bad time?
No, I meant this is a fun party.
So it's not fun?
What?
No?
Huh?
Oh!
What?
What?
Okay, Violet, I'm not sure I understand how to play this game. I'm confused.
It's easy. Just say the opposite of what you want to say.
So if I'm happy and it's opposite day, I should say I'm sad?
Yes, because sad is the opposite of happy.
Oh, they're antonyms.
Antonyms?
Did somebody say antonyms?
Scoops did, and then I repeated it out of confusion.
Let me help. An antonym is a word that's the opposite of another word. Since happy and sad are opposites, we call them antonyms.
Tall and short are antonyms.
So if I want to say how I'm feeling on opposite day, instead of saying I'm having a great time, I should say the antonym of great, or its opposite, which is terrible. I'm having a terrible time! Yeah!
Now you've got it!
The sky is green! Those leaves are blue! I'm having a miserable time on opposite day, and so aren't you!
Bob, you know, it's nice now and then to relax with friends without being interrupted by some late-breaking crime report.
This is a late-breaking crime report. As I speak, there's a robbery taking place down at the City Museum. Someone has broken into the fancy sales made of rare and expensive fabrics exhibit. Oh, if only Word Girl would show up and save the day!
Are you kidding me? Let's just sneak out, fix this, and hopefully we won't miss much of the party.
Hey, you two, where are you not going?
Don't follow me, Scoops. I've got to go buy more meatloaf.
If Becky wants us not to follow her, it means she actually does want us to follow her since it's opposite day.
No, wait. I meant to say, please follow me, everybody. See, that's what I meant.
No, opposite
day. Yeah, field trip. Oh, brother.
With this golden sail, I can repair my ship. I will borrow it. Borrow? No. Steal! No can!
While Nocan steals the golden sail, the opposite day party has taken over the grocery store.
Excuse me, I would not like to buy this can of Super Cran Cranalot because it tastes terrible and is not delicious.
Fine then. Don't buy it.
So here's a dollar.
What's this for?
Just go ahead and don't ring me up.
What is going on? Am I on a hidden camera show or something?
You definitely are on a hidden camera show.
Sorry about that, sir. You're not on a hidden camera show. You see, we're having an opposite day extravaganza, so we're saying the opposite of what we mean and using lots of antonyms.
Oh, I know what an antonym is.
It's a word that means the opposite of another word.
But what's an extravaganza? That sounds like some sort of tropical fruit.
Oh, an extravaganza is a spectacular party, a big fancy celebration.
Not a tropical fruit?
Not a tropical fruit.
Well, you learn something new every day. Say, this opposite day extravaganza is kind of fun. Let me try.
The food I sell tastes terrible. And be sure to tell your parents about our high, high prices.
You got it now. That's the spirit.
We interrupt this shopping music for this important news story. The theft at the City Museum continues, while Word Girl is nowhere to be found. Where could she possibly be? And now, more music to purchase cucumbers by.
We're stuck. I can't change into Word Girl with all these people around. They'll see me. Call off the party. But it's so much fun! Oh, I guess you're right. There's no time for parties when there's crime to fight. Everybody, I have an announcement to make. I hereby declare opposite day to be over, done, finished.
Over?
Finished?
Wait a minute, everybody. If it's opposite day and Becky says the party is over, that means the party is not over. Am I right?
Then opposite day continues!
Yeah!
Where are we not going now, Becky?
I guess we're not going to the City Museum. Uh-oh. Looks like Nocan the Contrarian is back. This could get ugly.
Yeah. Tiny peasant children, be gone!
That's Nocan the Contrarian. He always does the opposite of what people tell him to do. He loves antonyms.
Oh, so every day must be opposite day for Nocan.
I command you, you must leave me alone right now!
He's playing the opposite day game too.
What?
He told us to leave, so that means we should stick around.
No, leave! I don't need your help!
He needs our help.
No, I don't! Nocan needs no help holding this giant sail!
Let's help him!
Let's help him!
Let's help him!
Quick,
while they're distracted, Word up! Hold it right there, Nocan the Contrarian!
Wow, Word Girl!
Nocan, prepare for battle!
Word Girl!
girl.
Help me. These tiny peasants keep doing the opposite of whatever I ask them to do. This extravaganza is out of control. It's so annoying. No can, can't take it anymore.
That's funny, because, you know, you do that, you know, I don't know, like, all the time. Looks like you're getting a taste of your own medicine. Huggy, the sail!
My sail!
You really shouldn't go around breaking display cases and stealing things, Nocan.
But I'm only trying to fix my ship and sail home! Just help Nocan get rid of these pesky peasants!
If I tell you how to get rid of them, do you promise to leave the city and head back across the sea?
Yes, yes, right away!
Okay, what you have to do is...
I'll try it. Peasants! Please, help Nocan at once! Nocan needs you to stand very close to him, right away!
Okay, Mr. Contrarian, we'll leave you alone.
All you had to do was ask.
Well, that was easy. Now it's time for you to head home, Nocan.
Yes, home! Actually, Nocan can't head back to the land of Contraria until he finds a new sail for his ship.
A new sail for your ship, you say?
No!
The trampoline as a replacement sail. Good thinking.
Thanks. And that leaves only one thing left to do. Okay, everybody. Time to not head back to Becky's house. You don't have an opposite day extravaganza to finish.
Come on, Becky!
Well, thanks for not ending this extravaganza of antonyms. Join us next time for another boring, unfunny, and entirely predictable episode of Girl Word.
Word Girl!
Today's featured words are feisty and retire. It looks like another meeting of the Evil Villain Association. In this room are the most dangerous villains in the city.
Come to the snack committee meetings, but no one ever too busy to complain about the snack.
Can I count on your
support? Excuse me, would everyone kindly take a seat so we can start the meeting?
My back again.
The only evil villain who volunteered.
Excuse me.
I can't do this all by myself, you know.
Hey, super villains! Pay attention and sit down! Thank you. Now, I officially call to order this meeting of the Evil Villains Association. First order of business.
I got the first order of business right here.
What's going on? The cake isn't on the agenda.
It is now. Granny Mae, this is your party.
For what? It's not my birthday.
Well, you've reached the age where it's time for you to retire as a villain.
Retire? You've got your nerve! No one tells Granny Mae when to retire!
But
how dare you even think of getting rid of me? I'm still sharper than all of you!
Yeah, go, Granny, go, Granny, go!
I'm liking
Nicely
it.
Nicely done. Beautiful needlework. She may be old, but she's still quite feisty. Ooh.
Now, I think it's time to stop all this retirement talk and get on with our meeting. Unless anyone else has something to say about my age. No? Good.
Can I say something?
I dare you.
Let him speak, Granny Mae.
Thank you, Butcher. The Evil Villains Association Book of Evil Rules and Villainesses Laws says that a villain must retire when he or she reaches 75 years of age.
What? It says no such thing. Where does it say that?
All right. At age 75, all villains must retire. Try throwing a net around that.
What?
That's what it says. See? I don't make stuff up. At least not when it comes to association rules.
Let me see that. I have to hit the gas. Aha! You didn't read the small writing at the bottom.
If the retiring villain can capture Word Girl and bring her to the association, the villain does not have to retire. Unless they want to.
Ooh, imagine the crime sprees we could go on if we had Word Girl trapped right here.
But none of us have ever been able to capture Word Girl.
Well, yeah, she's got a point. Sorry, Granny Mae. Looks like you'll have to retire.
But I refuse to.
Here is your gold-plated watch. Use it to tell time.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, you can keep keep your watch. Granny May is the only one who tells Granny May when to retire.
Later at Granny May's lair.
I have to come up with a plan to capture Word Girl so I don't have to retire. I need to tap into a true weakness. Everyone has something they can't resist.
A lot of people can resist potato chips. I know I can't.
She does love words. Maybe she has a favorite book. That's it! I'll use her favorite book to trap her. Word Girl may be feisty, but I've got a lot more years of being feisty on my side.
I'll get it! You got Word Girl. What can I do you for?
Hello, Word Girl. This is Granny May.
Why the phone call? You never called me before.
Well, I don't know if you heard, but I was forced to retire from the Evil Villain Association.
Really? I didn't know you could retire from being evil.
I thought since I'm no longer a villain, we could be friendly.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes, my dear. We have so much in common.
Like what?
We are both female. Ha, yes, and, well, I just think an old feisty lady like me and a young feisty girl like you could have a wonderful time together.
I'm sorry, Granny May. Thank you for the offer, but we're really busy here today.
Oh, well, right. Of course. Okay, I'll just sit here alone and rock.
Well, okay. But we can only stay for a minute.
Great. Oh, I mean, thank you, Word Girl.
After we're done cleaning, it looks like we're headed over to Granny May's house. I know. I think she's up to something, too.
Later, at Granny May's lair, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face wait for some refreshments.
Be nice, Huggy. We don't want her to think we're suspicious of her. She thinks we came over because she was forced to retire. Retire? Well, it means to stop working. Like someday, when we're older, you and I will retire from our job as superheroes.
Do-do-do! I hope all my guests are hungry!
Thank you for your hospitality.
Well, now that I had to retire, I have a lot of free time on my hands. So, I thought it might be nice to start a book club.
A book club?
Yes! And I thought I would ask you first. You and your hungry friend.
I'm flattered you thought of us, but I'm afraid we'll have to pass.
Oh, okay. I was just looking forward to discussing Princess Triana with you.
Princess Triana and the Dragons of Nodding's Wash.
I did not know you liked this book! But, you're not staying, so maybe I'll discuss the book with the Drapes.
Well, have fun. We better get going.
For instance, I could ask the Drapes how they felt when Princess Triana went off to fight the dragon family by herself.
In Chapter 3!
Yes! I thought that was quite feisty of her, didn't you, Word Girl?
Yes, I was so scared when she went into that dragon cave.
Oh, I know. So what did you think when Princess Triana met her cousin, Lady Celestial, and claimed she didn't know the princess?
No, but she was just pretending so the dragons wouldn't harm Princess Triana.
Really? I don't remember that part. Are you sure?
Oh, I'm positive. I'll show you. It's right here in chapter... Oh! Oh, no! Old lady perfume! Huggy, we've been tricked!
Now, let me get my sweater and we'll be on our way! I gotcha! Here you go! If you want a job done right, get Granny May to do it!
Hey, now she doesn't have to respire!
You mean retire. Respire means to breathe.
Right, retire.
Well, as you can all see, I won't be needing this anymore. I am so happy I don't have to retire. Oh, I think I might just have to give all of you a hug!
Come here, Hugsies.
Oh,
Oh.
You did it all yourself, honey. You brought us Word Girl when no one else could.
Thank you, Two Brains. Now, as long as you have Word Girl, I might as well do a little pickpocketing in the park.
Oh, now where's my wallet?
Hey, Granny May stole her gold-plated watch back!
Oh, she's good. Pretending to be sentimental just to steal a watch? Whew, that is one feisty lady.
What should we do with Word Girl?
Maybe you should watch her while we go on a crime spree.
Sounds fair to me.
Well, it doesn't sound fair to me.
Let's see what it says in the book, shall we?
Look, they're trying to escape.
Don't let them get away!
Sirlight!
Let's get out of here, Huggy. We've got to get to the park and stop Granny May from her pickpocketing spree.
Excuse me, Sunny. Could you bend over and hand me my ball of yarn?
Sure. Here you go.
Give that man back his wallet.
Word Girl! Oh, I knew those guys would mess this up, and they wanted me to retire.
I think you made a mistake, Word Girl. This sweet old lady wouldn't steal my... Hey, that sweet old lady stole my wallet.
Finders keepers, baby! I forgot what a feisty competitor you are, Word Girl!
Feisty. Good word.
Yes, it means full of energy. Something feisty can also be difficult. Granny May is full of energy and hard to beat, and so am I. So that makes both of us feisty competitors.
But it turns out that I am feistier. Back to the association you go.
No!
Thank you, Word Girl. So, what's the standard tip? 20%?
Oh, no, please. Superheroes usually work for free.
A few days later, at the jail...
Chuck, what are you doing here?
I lost the coin toss. They want their gold watch back.
All right, I know when I'm beat.
That's right. You may have beat Word Girl, but you'll never beat Chuck, the evil sandwich-making guy. I am sharper than, something very sharp.
Hey, he's over there.
Oh.
Sharp as a butter knife is what you are.
And so we retire this episode. Be sure to tune in next time for another exciting adventure of your favorite feisty superhero, Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Cape not required. For more Word Girl adventures and word-filled fun, visit pbskidsgo.org. Word up!